I'm worried because I know I must leave all my sin and my friends in the world. I know that following Jesus means my life will change. Maybe the devil tempts me. I doubt. I ignore Jesus' call. But Jesus does not give up. He continues to call me again and again. The Holy Spirit comes to me and brings me near to Jesus, and I answer. Number two, I repent. Means I pray to God. I say, quote, Lord God, I am full of sin. Please forgive me. I rely on Jesus Christ. He died for me. Please change my life and bring me into your family. End quote. I can repent because Jesus suffered and died. Number three, I feel Jesus' touch. Means what? Do I feel someone touching my arm or my head? No. Jesus' touch means Jesus changed my life. He answers my prayer. He forgives my sin. He gives me new life. Then I can change. Before, I was full of sin, greedy, proud. Now I am different. I am full of love. I am honest, humble, holy. I want God's things, not my own things. This is what it means to know Christ. Paul knew Christ. Paul had been saved and changed. Paul served Christ. I should copy Paul. I should make sure Jesus Christ is the most important person in my life. Meaning number two, I learn about Christ. Paul always learned more and more about Jesus Christ. Paul always learned from Christ. Chapter 2, verse 5. Quote, in your life together, think the way Christ Jesus thought. End quote. Paul always copied Jesus, and he commanded Christian people to copy Jesus. Chapter 2, verses 6 to 7. Quote, he was like God in every way, but he did not think that his being equal with God was something to use for his own benefit. Instead, he gave up everything, even his place with God. He accepted the role of a servant, appearing in human form. End quote. I should copy Jesus' attitude. I should think, quote, Jesus wanted to leave heaven and come to earth. He wanted to suffer and die. Why? To save me. Jesus is wonderful. He is the best savior. End quote. When I learn about Jesus, I want two things. Oh, three things. Okay. Three things. Number one, I want to copy Jesus. Number two, I want to tell more people about Jesus. Number three, I want to serve Jesus. Meaning, number three, I see Christ's work. Maybe I have problems, or I need help. What should I do? I can pray. I can talk to Jesus, and he will answer me. He will help me and bless me. This is wonderful. Question. Do you pray for people? Do you ask God to save your friends and family? Do you ask God to help Christian people? You should. This is called intercession. Maybe I feel low. I do not feel God near to me. I say, quote, I have lost my assurance. What should I do? I should pray. I should intercede for people. Means I ask God to help them. Then I will see proof of Jesus' work. When he saves people and blesses them. Meaning number four. Everything belongs to Christ. Number one, my home belongs to Christ. I should use my home to serve Jesus. I should not allow sinful things into my home. I should not have big arguments and fights in my home. I should keep my home a nice place where I care for my family and raise my children well. Number two, my workplace belongs to Christ. Maybe I am the only Christian in my workplace. I must pray for my work colleagues. In the right time, God will give me an opportunity to speak to people about the gospel. I must show Jesus' character to my colleagues. Number three, my things belong to Christ. I must not buy selfish things, worldly things, sinful things. Whatever I buy, I must think, quote, would Jesus want me to have this? I remember, Jesus is near me, in my heart and in my life. I do not want him to feel upset because I have sinful things in my life. Meaning number five, I rely on Christ. I remember, my whole life belongs to Jesus. Why? Because he died on the cross for me. Without Jesus, I would go to hell. Without Jesus, my sin would control me. All my good things come from Jesus. All my righteousness comes from Jesus. I have no good things of my own. Jesus gives me everything. Example. I have a problem. The devil comes and says, quote, "You should feel upset. You should feel sorry for yourself. You should blame someone." End quote. No, I rely on Christ, and He gives me strength. Chapter 4, verse 13. Quote, "Christ is the one who gives me the strength I need to do whatever I must do." End quote. I am weak, but Jesus is strong. Example, my Christian friend says, quote, "Can you cover my job in the church? Or can you help me with something? Can you help serve God?" End quote. The devil comes and says, "That is not fair. That person is asking too much. You are tired. You work too much. Relax." No, I will not relax. I can do any work for God because Jesus gives me strength. I rely on Jesus. Some pastors say, quote, "No one in my church wants to help teach in Sunday school." No one wants to serve God. End quote. This is wrong. All Christian people should want to serve Christ. Why? Because He is the most important person in my life. Meaning number 6. I suffer for Christ. Paul knew that suffering for Christ is a great blessing. Chapter 1, verse 29. Quote, "He has also given you the honor of suffering for Christ." End quote. Chapter 2, verse 17. Quote, "Your faith makes you give your lives as a sacrifice in serving God. Maybe I will have to offer my own life with your sacrifice. But if that happens, I will be glad. I will share my joy with all of you." End quote. Paul knew maybe he would die. He knew maybe the Roman people would kill him, brackets, execute him. But he did not mind. This is a strange teaching, but it is wonderful. Sometimes Christian people will suffer for Christ. This is a great blessing. Many Christian people have suffered in the past, and many have died. Matthew chapter 5, verse 11 to 12, quote, "People will insult you and hurt you. They will lie and say all kinds of evil things about you because you follow me. But when they do that, know that great blessings belong to you. Be happy about it. Be very glad because you have a great reward waiting for you in heaven." End quote. I must be ready to suffer for Christ. I must accept people teasing me, hurting me. I will not stop preaching the gospel. Why? Because I love Jesus Christ. I know on the last day, I will share Jesus' glory. So now I share His suffering, and I am happy. 7, I change for Christ. Number 1, I change myself. And I became a Christian. I change myself. When I became a Christian, Jesus changed my life. He gave me a new life and a new heart. Now I can serve Him. After, what do I do? Change the world around me. How? It means I become involved in politics and campaign? No. I can change the world when I witness and tell people about Jesus Christ. When I witness, God uses my words. God changes people's hearts. And saves them. Then those people improve and become more holy. Some Christians say, quote, we must be involved in politics. We must improve the world. End quote. But I can see what has happened in the world. In the past 100 years, many things have improved. People are more healthy, they have more money, they have better jobs, and better homes. But their souls are suffering. Few people know God. People's lives have improved, but their souls are still spiritually dead. The world needs spiritual change more than social change. Number 3, I changed the church. Means what? Means I add a new teaching? No. Means I check the church every day and make sure we are following God's word, the Bible. Also, I challenge my Christian friends. I encourage people to follow God's way in the Bible. Example. Many Christian people do not keep Sunday, a holy day. This is terrible. We must change the church so we match the Bible's way. Meaning number 8. I focus on Christ. Philippians chapter 1, verse 1, quote, "The only important thing about living is Christ," end quote. This verse shows me that Paul focused on Christ. In everything Paul did, he served Christ. I should behave the same. I should give my whole life to Jesus. I should not keep anything for myself. I should plan my week. I should think, quote, "When will I pray? When will I read my Bible? How will I make time to go to the Bible study and prayer meeting?" End quote. Some Christian people say, "I want a long holiday. I want to fly around the world for 3 weeks." End quote. This is wrong. I should not focus on myself too much. I must focus on Christ. Means I am criticizing holidays? No. Holidays are good and nice. Sometimes it is good to relax. But I must be careful with my time. I must make sure I do not focus on myself too much. No. I give my whole strength to Christ. I give my whole life to Christ. I give my whole heart, soul, and mind to Christ. Philippians chapter 1, verse 1. Quote, "To me, the only important thing about living is Christ. And even death would be for my benefit." End quote. Question. What benefit would Paul get from death? Answer. He would go to heaven. Heaven is the perfect place. No suffering. No sin. No pain, no sadness. In heaven, there is only perfect joy forever. In heaven, I will meet many Christian people. I will meet Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. I will talk to them and discuss God's plans and God's ways. I will meet many Christian people in heaven. We will talk together and worship God together. We will sing beautiful hymns and worship forever. Heaven is a wonderful place. If I die, I will go to heaven and I will meet Jesus Christ. I will talk with him and fellowship with him forever. Remember, I live for Christ. Jesus is the most important person in my life. When I die, I will meet Jesus in heaven. Everything I do, I must focus on Christ. May the Lord help us all to rely on Him and focus on Him. Amen.
Amen. God, God, God.